If you want to say, how do you make an impact in a country that's struggling to develop? Well, any development economist will tell you, you start with education. And if the next question is, how do you, you know, how do you support that drive to improve education?
The focus is the Haitian community. It's about people helping people. That's it. That's what the Vassar Haiti Project does.
The Vassar Haiti Project was born out of an idea. The idea was, can we sell Haitian art in Dutchess County and raise money and then do something good with that money, something to benefit Haiti?
What we do is we buy art from Haiti and sell it at our art sales, which then we send the proceeds back to the small village of Chermaitre, where we're building a school and supporting nutrition and teacher salaries. So I think it's really cool that it's that it goes full circle, in that we're supporting the artist market in Haiti, and then we're also supporting education and nutrition in Haiti.
So we're accelerating their development by promoting a local industry and by promoting their culture. And I think that promoting their culture is also really important, because it shows that this country has been able to rise above everything that the first world has attempted to do to it, and can still assert its identity.
Education in Haiti needs a tremendous amount of help. There is no infrastructure really in Haiti supporting education right now. Education is mostly getting its support from nonprofit organizations.
We had a sale and we had extra money left over from what we usually send to Haiti. And we asked our partners in Haiti, what is it that you want? And they said, we wanted a school.
We had this conversation about what happens if we get to the next level. We got to the next level. We stopped talking about building a school in Chermaitre and we started building a school.
I went to Haiti last spring. When I went there, you know, I got to see the kids and see the school, and it just took shape in front of my eyes, and I understood that all of the efforts that we're making are worth it.
You know, it's not as if the project didn't exist that these people would stop surviving. That's never the case. But by going there and being a part of them and meeting them and seeing how much more potential we could bring out within a community like that through education, I guess it gave us a better picture of reality, in the sense that, you know, it's not about us and what we do, but it's really about them and what we can do for them.
We sat down with the school director and the school board and some of the teachers and had a conversation about what Chermaitre needs, like what's next. Most immediate goals were having a cistern to collect rainwater, getting a pump to pump water up from the stream, because it's on a mountain, so they have to go down and get all the water and carry it up. The water there from the stream needs to be purified, so we need to get a water purification system.
So when we got back to the States, we decided to take all those needs and all those requests into consideration, obviously, and try to fit them as best as possible. So what we decided was to actually kind of change the Vassar Haiti Project and divide and, like, create all these specific committees. You know, I saw that the hills were barren there, and that was the reason that I decided to become the reforestation committee chair this year.
When you think about fighting poverty or fighting hunger, it can get really overwhelming and scary, because it's this big, you know, thing, this concept that affects so many people, and it's the whole world, and how can you take on the whole world? And it just, you know, doesn't even make you want to do anything, because you don't even know where to start. And it really brought it home, being there in Haiti. It made it feel more manageable, that if you can, you know, kind of bite off this one piece and work on it, that's good and that's making a difference.
The problem with the liberal arts education is that, you know, although you can Although you're presented with the opportunity to study a wide range of things, all of it ends up being centered around you and how well you understand things around you, but it's really centered on the individual. You know, the Haiti Project gave me an opportunity to work for something bigger than myself, you know, and I've really needed that to feel like I was useful.
Merci.